Hello and welcome to another, Clan Battles replay cast. Today I'm gonna feature again me and Azal. Same map. And it's about some nasty plays that you can pull out and how important, again, positioning is. Even when you are in the. When you are about to win the game. But still, just play, stay focused. Alright, you know a lot of naval vision, you know our deployment, I guess, so it sticks more or less the same. We are kind of successful with it. The biggest issue we have right now with our setup or lineup is that we are just doing too many mistakes, and still this change from the 2DD setup we played last season towards the no DD setup makes it quite rough for some players, because you have to embrace this aggressive playstyle and go with it, but you at the same time you can't overextend. Okay, you shouldn't do that anyways, but it's really, really tricky. And we lost our Minotaur too often in the beginning, which leads us which results in no spotting and most of the time losing the game, since our Minotaur is not so experienced normally, and yes, learning this kind of playstyle. I mean, he played DD before, but of course in a DD you are smaller, you have less concealment, and you're a bit more nimble. And in a Minotaur it's almost the same what you're doing, but in a bigger size, so to say. But yeah, that's more or less our biggest issues. Alright, so I'm again in the north here at A. We are playing the weak side, so to call. Moskva and myself. Moskva for some radar coverage over A. We want to stall A as long as possible. I make sure I'm not ending up here, because that's probably overextending already. If the enemy is strong at A, I'd never come out of here just because of this, that I have to be like straight line this. And if I'm spotted by the DD, then it's going to be really nasty for me. But I will show you a nasty play I did. At least I think it was a great play, but how nasty the utilization of concealment is and how important it is. That's one big part I wanna show in this game. Let's go quickly over the lineup of the enemy. While there are Toss flying, I was expecting that since I'm located, and I expect the DD up here as well. So we are facing Blitz, who are running a 1DD setup. Two Raiders, two Zaos, Young, Hindenburg, Montana, pretty balanced. Like it. Okay, so I see a Hindenburg here. But I don't want to shoot him. Why is that? Well, first of all, he's turning away. Second of all, what does it bring to the table? Nothing. I'm giving away my position. The thing is, in a way, I gave away my position. Because that DD player, whoever has RPF running, should know that there are two targets up here. But we come to that in a second or a moment. So I'm just moving a bit around, not that I get caught off guard by any torpedoes or something like that. So you saw these shells up there? They came from here. They had these red stripes, means, and flood arcs. So it can't be Halsey, because Halsey, I would assume, being on the Montana, Worcester, or Des Moines. But except for Montana, it has some good low arcs, but compared to other battleships, not anymore. So I highly expect that they're up there. There is a Zao with the Yamamoto cap. So what am I doing now? You know that I didn't shoot. So now I'm just waiting patiently, because I think the goal is they just spotted the Moskva yet. So they might become a bit more eager and want to play more aggressive. While they are saying that our push down here is going to happen. So they are already retreating and start to kite. These guys think, oh, maybe there's another Moscow. Well, they are can't account for me as a Tsar. So now look who's having a big issue. That Tsar, yeah, he is making the crucial mistake. He's totally surprised. He tries to slow down and tries to angle. The thing is, if he angles, he's dead. He doesn't get out of my concealment, and we have the firepower of two ships. I'm angled, so I won't eat the most damage, even when he shoots AP. But we wanna target him down as quick as possible and just gain a minimal lead. But, I mean, there was one way out for him. If he reacted quick and turned out immediately. That was the only chance he had. The only chance. Nothing else. And that's what I mean with nasty plays. I mean, if you're on a radar minotaur, you can also do such nasty things. You can even... pretty nasty towards enemy Tsars, because you have to conceive an advantage. Yeah, the enemy Hindenburg is hammering me, but I don't care. He's way too far away. The issue for the Tsar was that the Hindenburg wasn't close enough, so he couldn't support him. And that cost him his life. He overextended and was not in a line with the Hindenburg to push. And also, they should have known that there is someone else up here, except for the Moskva. So, yeah, that's exactly what you can do to with the nasty concealment value. Nasty, okay, a good concealment value, and how you utilize it. Expected, of course, torps again at some point. We are rotating our hydroacoustic, so we minimize the chances of the enemy DD to land torps on us. Of course, we are staying kind of angled. RPF helps as well. So from now on, I just turn around, and we are playing aggressive on A now, since we are outnumbering the enemy by 2-1. And yeah. Our team struggles a bit down there at C to get it in their hands. Seems as if the enemy is doing a lot right and make it hard for our team. Our Montana goes down, but that can happen and is always accounted for, since he is just the one who's pushing the most. And our Moskva, Mazru, he's trying to get some nasty shots in. Broadsides, so that's about the Moskva thingy with crossfire. Yeah. And that's basically it about the game. I mean, Blitz didn't play bad, that's for sure. But you see how minor mistakes can lead to, almost a loss. I mean, if you lose one ship, that's quite significant. So you want to avoid that as best as possible. And here he was just alone, and the Hindenburg was not in line. So, of course, in the Tsar you're always pretty comfortable, because you have the second best concealment value among all cruisers. But that can go horribly wrong, as you just saw, especially against good teams who know how to play around and are patient with their concealment, like I was. So that's a thing you should definitely account for. Yeah, well, now it's pretty easy. Our Moskva is going into A and capping me probably as well. So we get the lead, and we stop the point gain for the... Well, not completely, but enemy has only one. cap point, and by this time, I think if we don't lose too many ships right now, then we should be able to do it. I said in the beginning something about positioning, and you will see it with Crash. There was also a misunderstanding. So I saw Masaru's HP going down, but Masaru put himself in a position where he can use this island as a blocker towards the enemy, so he can't be shot at. And that's so in a stationary cruiser, that's it's a really great positioning, because sooner or later you can't withstand that. And if you don't have any place to retreat to, you go down pretty quickly, as Crash will find out, because he is not in a certainly bad position. But he's in the range of the Wooster, and if the Wooster can shoot him without any return fire, maybe behind an island and not being spotted, then he has a hard time to survive. So the thing for him is, yeah, it's anyways a pretty bad position, I have to say right now. I mean, I said maybe go there, so it's also on me a bit. Maybe you should have played kiting or something with me up here. I'm spotting for him and he stays out of the concealments. That's probably a thing I could have done, or we could have done, because we have this crossfire area anyways already, so yeah. But you also see that Blitz is playing around. The Montana stopped shooting when he was going low, which is a smart move, because this game is still really close, and as you see, we are about to lose Crash, which gives the enemy favor, the advantage again. So at that point, they can just gamble and hope that they have enough points till the end. But yeah, if no one of our team is dying, it shouldn't happen, I guess. I of course try to apply pressure, try to get some spotting done, but yeah. That's a crucial part of positioning. Yeah, if there is a Wooster or Des Moines down here that you can shoot without being spotted, maybe get smoked by the Yuyang or something, then you have a really, really hard time. So always take that in consideration when you choose a position for your stationary cruiser. As you see, Masaru has always these shots. He's going up here and has shots in this area, but between that he has this little island. And of course, that's kind of a thing really good players are known for, because it needs some experience and skill to find these positions. And maps are changing, etc, so there's a lot going on. Luckily for us, this loss doesn't mean anything. We could overtake Blitz again in the end, and yeah. Now it's too late for them, and they can't do much anymore. And we'll lose this game. But I have to say, I think we played 2 times against Blitz, and they played pretty well. I was not expecting that. So it looks as if a lot of people are improving and getting really good now. The third season, yeah, you realize it. Okay, hope that was enjoyable. And how can I say it? Helpful, maybe, to play around with your concealment. Of course, it's recommended to do it in ships like Zhao or Minotaur. You understand me. I mean, with the Hindenburg, it's quite tricky to pull something off. I did there. Maybe the Des Moines is also possible. It's also capable of like surprising a Hindenburg maybe, but that are already ranges beyond 10 kilometers, so they are a bit further away, even for Des Moines. But yeah, using concealment, positioning, doing what to do when it's the time to do so, etc. Yeah, okay, thanks for watching, guys. Hope you liked it. Give it a like if so. If you are the first time watching this, I would really appreciate a subscription. Other than that, if you have something to comment on, do it in the comments. I'll gladly answer. And yeah, nevertheless, have a good day. See you next time. Bye-bye.